So what did we find? We found that among these distributions, the exponential distribution now has the highest entropy. So all of a sudden we can say, well, the fact that it kind of looks exponential now makes sense. Because if we take it as a given that there's a constraint about the firing rate that a neuron has long term, what's the best interspike interval distribution? Well, we will see that it's the exponential. So what about real neurons? Now, like we said, on the right-hand side, they kind of look like an exponential. How close is that? Well, mind you, we have our histogram that we calculated before. So what we now want to do is we want to convert this histogram into a probability distribution. How can we do that? Well, in fast approximation, correctly as we go towards large numbers, we have that the probability that we land in a given bin is the number of times that we landed in that bin divided by the overall number of spikes that we have. No, that's the probability that we're in one of those. And with this, we can convert a histogram into a probability distribution. Now it is your turn to do that. You take the histogram and you convert it into probabilities.